If men really did walk on the moon in the 1960s and 70s, we'd have been back by now. Therefore, we've never been to the moon. Well, no, we have been to the moon, and there's a reason why we haven't been back. Today on Vintage Space. All right, as to why we haven't been back to the moon since Apollo 17 left in December of 1972, this is a huge answer, so I'm just gonna give you guys the Coles Notes today. We can't talk about why astronauts haven't been back to the moon since the 1970s without discussing the reason we went to the moon in the first place. The decision to go to the moon ultimately boiled down to a show of strength. The Soviet Union was leading in space because it had larger rockets that were able to launch heavier payloads into orbit, things like Sputnik 2 with the dog Laika and eventually Yuri Gagarin. This meant that the Soviet Union had better technology and had better rockets that posed a threat to the United States. And so the United States responded in kind. President Kennedy seized on space as the way to show America's technological dominance in 1961. Now, he wasn't the first person to ever think about going to the moon. People had been thinking about a lunar landing mission for years before he pledged America a moon landing by the end of the decade in 1961. Men like Wernher von Braun, but also the US Air Force and the US Army. All of these institutions had ideas on how to go to the moon, and it was really just the presidential support for the fastest way possible that led to Apollo. So Apollo was really the quick and dirty way to meet a national goal to show that the United States was stronger than an enemy. This meant the spacecraft were tailor-made for the Apollo mission that we know, that is the Lunar Orbit Rendezvous mission. The movie Capricorn 1 shows an Apollo lunar module on Mars. It could never survive entry onto that planet. When Apollo 13 had to bring its lunar module home, it disintegrated, burning up in the atmosphere. This was a single-use vehicle only for landing on the moon. The command module and the service module could have been used maybe for a different mission, as we saw with Skylab and Apollo Soyuz, and some early proposed missions to take it to Mars and Venus, albeit as orbital missions only. So while the core spacecraft of the command service module was actually quite capable, it ultimately didn't have the architecture to lend itself to a larger long-term program. Not to mention the Saturn V rocket that it needed to launch was really expensive. Cuts to the Apollo program came in the late 1960s. The program was supposed to go through to Apollo 20, but the last three missions were ultimately canceled. And with President Nixon coming in at the end of the decade, he canceled Apollo altogether because he had a very different vision for space than his predecessors. Nixon wanted space to be part of America's overall thinking. He didn't want to move forward in space with leaps and bounds like another Apollo program to land on Mars or to do something else. He wanted space to be something regular and routine, and with that, he wanted to cancel missions beyond low Earth orbit. So it was Nixon who ultimately canceled the Apollo program in favor of a space shuttle and space station program. Of course, he only funded the shuttle and not the station right away, so we ended up with a shuttle shuttling to nowhere until the ISS was built. And the shuttle was purpose-built for that mission. It was designed to shuttle astronauts between Earth and low Earth orbit. It could never have gone to the moon. It could never have gone further. So why haven't we been back to the moon since Apollo 17? Well, the same reason we went in the first place. Politics. There just hasn't been a national pressing need to do something as big as go back to the moon. We might see it again, we might not. But ultimately, if it's going to be with a public sector and not a private company, it's going to have to take something massive on a national scale to light that fire under us again to get back to the moon. At least that's my opinion. Like I said, this is a massive question and something that I actually want to dig into on my inaugural podcast, which I promise you guys is coming. My summer has been insanely busy and I just haven't had the time. So let me know what kinds of topics you guys would like for me to take on in a podcast in the comment section below. And a special shout out to the Vlogbrothers for helping make this episode possible. Be sure to follow me on Twitter and on Instagram for daily Vintage Space content. And with new videos going up every Friday, subscribe right here so you never miss an episode.